My name is Igor, and in this video, we'll be using the brand new ChatGPT to create better content faster than ever before. Actually, these strategies are absolutely going to help you to take your work to the next level. So let's dive right in. First up, let's talk about scripting intros, as this is the one that I already used in this video. Yes, I absolutely use AI to enhance my own content creation, but here's an important fact that you need to consider. I only use it to support my content creation. I don't take it word by word, and I feel like that is so important. So let me show you how I use this. Write me a video intro on the topic of AI content creation. Okay, so it produced a lengthy script that is spoken in a pretty generic voice. I would never speak like this. So let's tell it, now summarize that in one paragraph in a conversational tone. Okay, so that's way better. But again, I would not just use this straight up. I don't think that's a good idea. Because for myself, the video creator here, what I have in mind is bringing you as much value as possible. I want you to take away things from this video that you will actually use. And ChatGPT mentions things like bias in here, which absolutely is an important topic, but not important to you getting the most results. So I didn't mention it in my own intro. So what I'd rather do is tell it, turn that into bullet points. Okay, that's more like it. I could take these and freely speak the intro. But overall, I think you should try it yourself. If it creates a script, try reading them off a teleprompter or off the screen. All I can tell you is that that doesn't work for me, and these bullet point scripts are the way to go. I'd rather repeat a sentence 3 times on camera to get it just right, just the way I want it, and then edit out the parts that don't work, instead of relying on AI to be the voice in my head. I don't think that's what I would want if I watched videos, and I assume the same for you. Okay, next up, let's talk about ChatGPT helping you with the creative process. And for anybody saying AI chatbots are not good enough to compete on creativity with humans, at this point in time in December 2022, I would just say they're plain wrong. Emotional damage! Let's have a look at a useful prompt. Write me some creative video ideas around AI content creation. Now that's amazing, and yes, if I sat down and noted these, I could have come up with similar concepts, but it thinks differently than you because it learned from a different data set than you did. And that's why this can be a great creative assistant. And to anybody saying,
yes, but a human could do that too.
Sure, but try telling a human, give me 20 more. I can keep doing this. So many good ideas. Honestly, let me just copy this and I'll read through this later. But one that I particularly like is this one, number 3. Create a video that explores the ethical implications of AI in content creation, such as the potential for bias and loss of human creativity. So I could go in and say, give me 5 YouTube video ideas for number 3. And wow, come on, it just takes so many different viewpoints into consideration. I love this. Look, a roundtable discussion with experts in AI and ethics, interviews with artists and creators who have used AI, the role of AI in creation of fake news. There's just so many inspirations in here that you can go off. And is this the end-all be-all solution? No. I always take this and process it myself, pick the best parts, and then create around that. Just like this thing can generate video ideas, it can also generate Instagram captions. Let's just say, write me 20 Instagram captions for my trip to Italy. This is fantastic. But these would be perfect for a young girl posting. For myself, I would prefer it to have a little bit more of a funny note. So let's say, now write me 5 in the style of the Holy Bible.
And it came to pass that the traveler journeyed to Italy and was filled with wonder at the sights and sound of the land.
Hashtag Bibleverse. I probably wouldn't post that, but this was fun. The ideation process is so key, and now you have this assistant that can do it forever without complaining, tiring, or running out of ideas. If you're enjoying this content, take a second to like and subscribe, but now let's move on to the next point. Okay, next up, I want to show you a creative way I used it to improve my content today. It actually saved me like 2 hours of manual work. So my goal here was to subtitle my YouTube video because a lot of international people watch these. But the biggest problem with the auto-generated subtitles is it has no capitalization or punctuation. So 2/3 of the time here, I don't spend correcting the subtitles, but actually inserting capitals or commas where they belong. And I have an admission to make. I'm not the best at punctuation. I had a problem with it in school and I kind of always ignored it. So I forget to place the right commas at the right time sometimes. But I want the best experience for my viewers. So what do I do here? Even if I try my hardest, this is not going to be perfect. Well, now we luckily have ChatGPT. So just copy the first part here and I'll say punctuate the following text correctly. And then I insert it in quotation marks. Boom, done. Copy. Paste. And for anybody saying,
hey man, Microsoft Word could have done that.
Nope, it couldn't. It's not this good. I tested it. Similarly, it could proofread and punctuate your scripts, blog posts, emails, or even your Instagram caption if you decided to pour your heart out. Okay, my last point, I want to show you one of my favorite functions here, the summary creator. When I set out to create a video for YouTube, I want to make it as fun as possible. I want to put thought into the preparation process, have fun with the recording, and fine tune it all in the editing. What I do not want to do is write a description for the entire video. Well, I don't have to anymore. So as I just showed you, we have these subtitles that are created by YouTube here. I could just copy those and tell ChatGPT, summarize this text into a YouTube description. And again, in quotation marks, we post it. And this is just perfect. Literally, it summarizes the whole video in one sentence, then it states the 3 points that I covered throughout the video, and it uses all the keywords that I would want in there. Look at that. Dangers of AI, ChatGPT, manipulated, illegal activities. Honestly, I'll just use this. You can compare it to the one I came up with by myself. I'll add some points that it left out, and it just made my content way better, but not by replacing me, by helping me out. So as you can see, I think this technology is at its best when it's used as an assistant. We all know those AI video channels where everything is pre-scripted and an AI voice speaks it, and it's just generic stock footage on top. And while there is value there, it's not the content that I gravitate towards naturally. I want to hear from another person, but you can judge this yourself. In this video, I used it to help me with the intro bullet points, but otherwise, look, this is literally my entire script. I mean, the recording is 40 minutes long because I repeat something sometimes until I'm happy. And look, it seems to be working. You're still watching, right? And I think this approach is the ideal template to create quality content. Use it as support, but always stick to your mind's voice and your opinions. And if you enjoyed this video, you're gonna love this one, because ChatGPT can literally superpower your everyday life by just knowing what to ask it. I also started a weekly newsletter so you can get the maximum from this revolutionary tech. Sign up link is in the description, and I'll see you soon.